Going to work on it some more, and it was finally finished in 1942. Now, Howells earlier in the 30s had taken his wife and his son on a trip to Italy, I believe it was, and during the trip, their 9-year-old son contracted polio and died within 3 days. And that really kind of stayed with him for the rest of his life. His music is very tinged with this kind of intense melancholy and longing. And right on the top of that, you know what happened in England in the 1940s, 1941. And this music reflects the kind of turmoil that England was going through in the throes of World War II and the bombing of London, and also his intense sorrow about his son. There are moments of lightness in it, but you're going to hear echoes of war, and you're going to hear much lamentation and sorrow, and you're also going to hear a lot of reconciliation and peace in this. And before the greatest oboist in the world comes to play for you, I want to introduce him to you. It's Kip Zimmerman.
Hello, wonderful to be here. My name is Kip. I'm from Tucson, Arizona, and I hope you enjoy this music. Thank you.
we'll take a short break and recover from that and return with some Loeffler and Brahms. See you in about Loeffler. Loeffler, the music that you're going to hear sounds very French, impressionistic, but Loeffler was American-German composer, and he's chosen two, I call them symbolist poems, and they're full of strange imagery, and he uses those to weave these beautiful rhapsodies for viola and oboe and piano. And I have asked Kip to read the two poems to you. The first one is called The Pool, and the second one is called The Bagpipe. Oh, wait a minute, before he does that, I have to introduce you to Paul Lariat, who is a violist, and he will say two sentences about his long life.
Hello, everybody. I'm Paul. I play viola, and for anybody that's used to what a traditional viola looks like, you might be wondering. This one's a little bit extra cool. This was made by a maker outside of Philadelphia, a Japanese-American maker who's become very famous since the 80s. The Berlin Philharmonic commissioned an entire section of his instruments in the 80s, actually. So you might know the famous Michael Tree. Michael Tree from the Guarneri String Quartet was one of the first proponents of these instruments. And in my regular life, I play in a full-time string quartet. So I'm honored to be able to play with amazing colleagues, oboe and piano. Thank you.
That's my name.
All right, the first of the two poems, as Dr. Lauerstedt mentioned, is titled The Pond. Full of ancient fish, stricken by blindness, the pond, under a low sky rumbling with muffled thunder, shows among its centuries-old reeds the lapping horror of its density. Over there, elfin spirits act as lights for more than one black swamp, sinister and feared. But the pond is revealed in this deserted place only by the terrible noises of consumptive toads. For the moon, which rises just now, mirroring itself there so fantastically, that seeing its ghostly face, its flattened nose and strangely rippled teeth, it might see a death's head lit from within that had come to admire itself in a clouded mirror. The bagpipe. His bagpipes in the woods wind like the wind that bellows, and never the stag at bay, never the willow nor the skull has wept like this voice. Those sounds of flute and oboe were like the death rails of a woman. Ah, near the crossroad of the crosses, his bagpipes. He is dead, but under the cold skies, as soon as the night weaves itself, always in the depths of my soul, there at the point of old terrors, I hear wailing, just as of old, his bagpipes.
Thank you.
Francis David Carr. We call him Frankie. And he's from England, and I want them to say just a word to you, and then we'll go with the Brahms.
Hello, everybody. My name is Abby. It's so great to be back here on this beautiful, nice, less than humid day. I remember the last year was quite a bit warmer and felt like I was working a lot harder. I am normally, during the year, playing in a string quartet, actually with Paul here. We're both in the Catalyst Quartet based in New York City, but we travel all over the place. And it's just great to be here to be playing some lovely Brahms with these lovely people.
Hello, everyone. It's fantastic to be here. My name is Frankie. I come from England originally, but I came over here for my undergrad to Curtis and just finished last year. And it's wonderful to be here. So thank you so much for having us.
Yeah, it's fine.
Ready?
Thank you. Thank you.